There are many factors that contribute to cardiovascular disease, but among the most impactful is elevated blood pressure. Fortunately, it's also one of the factors that we can change the most dramatically. In fact, even small changes can offer outsized benefits in protecting against things like your brain blowing open, or by prim terms, suffering a stroke, or your heart saying, nah, I've had enough, or in prim terms, suffering a heart attack. We also know that exercise is one of the major players in reducing blood pressure. But believe it or not, the crown for the best blood pressure reducing ability is held by a weird type of exercise. So let's discuss the data. There are several types of exercise, from general terms like resistance training and endurance training to more specific descriptions like biking, running, push-ups, lifting some iron, crushing some skulls, and maybe I took that last one a bit too far. The point being, there are different types of exercise, yet only one reigns supreme ruler of the galaxy. But instead of me yapping on about it, I had the distinct honor of having a lovely conversation with Gil from Nutrition Made Simple on this very topic. Dr. Gil Carvalho has his medical doctorate and his PhD and describes this really well. So let's listen in, and then we'll come back with the data from two meta-analyses, including up to 270 studies. Yes, you heard that right, 270 studies.
And there's studies looking at the best exercises to lower blood pressure, which a lot of people struggle with. And they looked at everything. They looked at cardio. They looked at lifting weights. They looked at running, cycling, like all of this list. And isometric was at the very top.
Okay, so isometric exercise. We'll return back to Gil on a protocol for how to use isometric exercise to lower blood pressure. But for the time being, let's crack open some of these analyses to get a clearer picture of what Gil is talking about. If we lean on this analysis, the researchers pooled 270 studies and quantified the blood pressure effect of a bunch of different exercise types. Then, because this is what's known as a network meta-analysis, the researchers are able to compare the magnitude of the effect, i.e. how much blood pressure was lowered, through indirect comparisons of many exercise types. They actually show that in what's known as a Bayesian ranking panel, we have different exercise types abbreviated on the right side there. The higher up into the green that it goes, the better the probability that the treatment is the most effective. You can see that the control is at the very bottom. That's usually the no exercise condition. Then at the very top, you can see IET. That stands for isometric exercise training, exactly what Gil was talking about. Then Gil says something else that's really astounding.
They saw a reduction of 10 points, 10 millimeters mercury, with the program of the isometric exercises, which is in the same range as you often get with blood pressure lowering meds. It's kind of an amazing result.
A 10 point drop in blood pressure. That's a huge drop, especially as we'll get into how easy this is. If we pop open that same analysis as before, and we look at a forest plot of the data, this is a shortened for ease of understanding, we can see isometric exercise training up top here. Then the researchers have broken it up by three different versions of isometric training: isometric hand grip, leg extension, and wall squat. The red diamond and the black dots correspond to the average result of all the studies combined. In this case, 24 studies. That thick black line indicates no blood pressure lowering effect. So if the diamonds and the dots fall to the right, that indicates a blood pressure lowering effect. We can see that in total, isometric exercises reduce systolic blood pressure, that's the top number on your blood pressure readings, by about 8 points. However, something like wall squats is estimated to reduce blood pressure by around 10 points. Pretty remarkable, and confirmed in this analysis as well. But how do we use this information? What kind of protocol could we follow? Well, we'll dive into that next. If you're interested too, I wrote a detailed research review going into some more of the nuances in other exercises. If you're a Physionic Insider, you have access to it, including the Insider Podcast, a full library of videos and articles with applicable takeaways, and much more. It's linked in the description if you're so inclined. But let's discuss how to implement isometric exercise. It's really simple, which is why the blood pressure effect is additionally amazing.
So just to give one quick example of what a program could look like, doing a wall squat for a minute or two, if you can hold it, if not, you start shorter. And then as your capacity increases, you increase the length, but basically a minute or two of a wall squat, then rest for a couple minutes, do four sets of that two or three times a week. That's literally like a few minutes of your day, and it can have these kind of amazing results, and certainly at the level of blood pressure.
Yep, pretty simple. Doing a wall squat looks like this. You hold a 90 degree seated position against a wall for 1 to 2 minutes, work up to it if you can't do that, and you do that for 3 to 5 times per session. You would also perform 2 to 5 sessions per week. The greatest bang for your buck, it would probably be in that 2 to 3 times per week range. That's literally it. But Gil also said this, which I found pretty funny.
So there's a couple of things like that. And the beauty of that is they're pretty quick. They are free of charge. You don't need to go to some fancy gym to do. You can do it in your home. You can do it anywhere. You can do it at work. And you have a break. You go outside, you lean against a building and you squat. It might look ridiculous to passers-by, but you can do it anywhere. You can do it in the bathroom.
The great sitting revolution. People randomly rising up from their desks, going outside, lining the walls of buildings in a static squat position. Thousands of them lowering their blood pressure in the bushes, against light poles, against parked cars, against each other, back to back. It's a funny mental image. Anyway, check out Gil's channel where we discuss more health tips in a video of his. It'll be linked in the description. Or if you're interested in more on the power of exercise and heart health, check out this next video. It discusses reversing your heart's age.